people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, the PNP presidential race has taken a very dark and sinister turn because now lives are being lost. Down there in Hanover, the MP for, I think it's East Hanover, is a man by the name of Ian Hales, right? And it turns out at a PNP meeting, tensions flared and Ian Hales got into an argument with some men who were backing Peter Phillips. And just to be clear, Ian Hales is backing Peter Bunting. And in the process of this argument, a man by the name of Delroy Clark, right, basically stepped into the argument, and he was taking sides with the MP, Ian Hales, because Delroy Clark is also supporting Peter Bunting, right? And basically, man and man start argue. Delroy Clark tell the man them bought them chicken parts, right? Big dispute flare up in the meeting. But then afterwards, when the meeting was finished, the man then plan and set for Delroy Clark, right? And basically, let's just put it this way, his body was found in a gully, right? Now, the police are theorizing that obviously the reason why he lost his life is because of the earlier argument he had with the fellow PNP comrade. Now, if you notice carefully, this incident happened Tuesday gone, and you would think something as big as this would be all over the news, right? But for some reason, only nationwide seems to be the only station that is picking this up. And to be fair, Nationwide has been one of the most fearless news organizations over the years, so they are reporting on it, right? But the police have said they've actually arrested two men in connection with what happened to Delroy Clark, right? But so far, the police are also saying they're looking for a third suspect, right? And they haven't caught that one yet. But I just want people to realize the turn of events that is taking place in this PNP presidential race, right? And to make things worse, the police are now saying that Ian Hales, right, who is the MP Eastern Hanover, they're saying his life is now in danger because the same set among them who him did get into an argument with when Delroy Clark intervened are now after him. So now the police want to speak to Ian Hales to make him know, right, that basically he has to be careful and look out because people are after him. People are wanting to realize that these things are happening in 2019. Okay, people make it sound like political conflicts done long time from the 80s and 90s, and it's not true, right? But what makes this one stand out is because normally we hear about PNP versus JLP, but this one is internal, PNP versus PNP, right? And a thing that I don't like is the fact that if something like this happened, right, a big PNP meeting keep, people on different sides, basically Bunting side catch up with Peter Phillips' side, and then a man end up losing life. You see, in that situation, what I would love to see is Peter Phillips and Peter Bunting come out and say, listen, comrades, hold the peace. Okay? Don't make, because of election, you're going to start spill each other's blood. Okay, both of them need to come out and show a unified face and say, listen, at the end of the day, we're all on the same side here, right? And we want peace to reign, not just in the party, but in the country. But if you notice, the two man them act like nothing a go on. The two man them act like somebody didn't just lose them life sake of their presidential race, right? And it's almost as if they're hoping for it to go away, right? And I think the reason why they're keeping quiet is because, as I said, the news stations are not pressuring them, and they're not loading up what happened. I'm sorry, but this is a major incident. How can PNP and PNP figure meeting and sake of that man end up get found in a gully, right? And it is the police who are theorizing this. And if you use common sense, you wouldn't need the police to tell you that, right? Man got PNP meeting, Bunting side versus Phillips side. PB catch up in a big argument. PB send all kind of threats to each other. Man tell people about this part of them body and that part of them body. And right after meeting done, man get fined in a gully. It doesn't take a genius to figure out what happened, right? So I don't understand why Peter Phillips, as the leader of the party, is not coming out and saying, listen, Wagwan, down at East Hanover, a foolishness, and make sure it don't happen again, right? I know the election is just around the corner, and they were throwing things on their mind, but what can be more important than people losing their life over politics, right? And the worst thing is, people in Hanover are saying the 87 octanes and the 90 octanes in Hanover have already picked their side. They've already picked who they want to be the leader, right? Because when that leader in power, then get to eat a bigger food. Right, this is 2019. And these things are still happening to this day. To the point where a current sitting MP now has to be looking over his shoulder. Right? Because he's come out and said he's backing Bunting. Right? And sake of that, you saw what happened to Delroy Clark, who is also a Bunting supporter and who was defending Ian Hales. Right? Maybe the reason why nothing ever happened to Ian Hales is because obviously you'd be under much more pressure if you take out an MP than if you just knock down an activist, because Delroy Clark was an activist. One of them old time diehearted PNP, I think he was like 53 years old. Right? But still, if Ian Hill's life is now in danger, because he's taking sides against somebody who them don't want him to take side with, then that's foolishness. What they're trying to do, use intimidation to get people to vote for who them want them to vote for. I mean, we used to hear some them thing they cut out. But clearly it's a lie. Clearly it's still going on. The more things change, the more them stay the same. Right? So now, as I said, the third man still out there. At least them catch two of them right away. Right? And as I said, it's same PNP man them. Right? Everybody can identify them, everybody know them, because all of them go to the same meeting. Right? All of them are support the same party. And up until this presidential race, then did a roll as one. But now that the division has happened, and people have to take sides, you see, it's now lead to people having them blood spill. To the point where a big old 53-year-old man are losing life over politics. I can't believe it. Well, sorry, what am I saying? I can believe it. But when you see this blatant, right, and in this day and age, you really have to shake your head, right? I really think Peter Phillips needs to come out and make a statement condemning what happened in Hanover and making it clear, say, listen, make sure that nothing like this not happening again. Even if he doesn't mean it. Just a symbolic gesture. Right? We can't be having people that lose their life sake of politics in 2019. That's nonsense, people. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless up.